We are here in Kalinzo, Uganda, where we are going to track chimpanzees, the species closest to us. So please follow me into the forest.
Chimpanzees are our closest living relatives. Both of us branched off a common ancestor about 6 million years ago. This troop here has been habituated to human presence and they are not bothered by us. They sit high in the trees and we can watch them only from down here. Chimpanzees live in troops with permanent males. Once females become sexually mature, they move to another group. You will see this is a recurring pattern. One of the sexes, usually the males, but here those are the females, are moving to other groups. This prevents genetically deleterious inbreeding. Chimps have a highly complex yet flexible social structure. Once the female is in heat, she will mate with multiple males. This might be the reason that males have such big testicles, as their sperm has to compete with the sperm of other males. Gorillas, that we unfortunately did not observe, live in a harem of one male with several females. As there is no competition to the sperm of this male, his testicles are much, much smaller. Tragically, deforestation and hunting are endangering the survival of chimps in the wild. Jane Goodall started to study them in the 60s, and her observations completely transformed how we understand animal behavior in general and chimpanzees in particular. When she observed for the first time that chimps use tools, in this case a thin branch to catch and eat termites, nobody believed her. It was widely accepted that only humans use tools. Today we know that many animals use tools. For example, this sea otter we observed in California that uses a rock to break open clams. While humans are the most successful monkey, I would rate the baboons as the second most successful ones. Baboons surpass all apes that have much larger brains but that are all confined to shrinking tropical forest habitats and hover on the brink of extinction. What is the secret of their success? Baboons descended like us from the trees and learned how to live on the ground. Life on the savanna is not a picnic, or in fact, it is a picnic for the predators. To survive on the savanna, one must learn how to adapt, but once a species has mastered it, it can handle every challenge. Indeed, baboons are common and successful from South Africa to the edge of the Sahara, more than any other monkey. In fact, they are one of the very few wild large mammals that are not confined to reserves and that can be found everywhere. This is a good place to discuss family life of baboons. Like of this family that occupies our picnic table and prevents us from enjoying our lunch. We could use another table, however, as soon as we will take out our food, they will start harassing us. Baboons are very cheeky. In Namibia, they raided our car and stole my son's cereals. In Uganda, a baboon jumped into the driver's seat and dropped our toiletries while I was looking for something in the back of the car. Most predators respect baboons and keep a safe distance. But occasionally they fall victim to predation. Here, it looks as if the croc is going to get one, but he didn't. We saw a baboon shortly after he was killed by a leopard while picnicking on a bank in Zambia. A bit scary to think that the leopard must be still on one of the trees around us. At night, they sleep for safety's sake on a tree. Like us, they have a highly developed color vision that comes with a relatively weak nocturnal one. Baboons eat plants and sometimes meat. Here we see them looking for undigested morsels in elephant dung. Impalas and baboons can often be seen together. Impalas, like the fruits, baboons drop while foraging on the tree. Moreover, in the thicket, the more eyes and ears available, the better to spot predators and warn from them. The highly developed social structure is, in addition to the intimidating canines, the key to their success. They live in stable troops of several tens of individuals. The females remain permanently in these groups. Each female has a family that comprises of her offspring. Between females, there are complex patterns of friendship as well as dominance. These patterns affect also the members of their families. Males born in the troop leave it as they grow and join other troops. In these, they gradually rise in hierarchy. This rise depends on friendships they forge with females and their families. Here we see a young male befriending a female and her baby. Alliances he forges with other males as well as fights enable him to rise in the social rank. This complex sociality requires each baboon to know many individuals and to recognize numerous modes of behavior, body language and voices. The female ovulates every 6 months. When a female is approaching estrus, her buttock swells and gets pink, as you can see here. Initially, the female solicits younger males to mate with her. However, as ovulation approaches, when the chance of conception is maximal, the female will mate with one, two, or all dominant males of the troop. Pregnancy lasts 6 months. The fact that the female mates with different males increases the genetic variability. In addition, the expulsion of males reduces inbreeding between genetically close individuals. Baboons spend a lot of time grooming each other, which keeps them clean and plays an important social role. Mutual grooming can be found in many monkeys as well as in impalas and zebras. Neonate baboons are black and have a pink face. Not only we, but also the baboons consider this to be cute, and they are strongly attracted to black babies. After they are born, many troop members come to play with the baby. Babies lose the black color at about 6 months of age. Young baboons play a lot, much more than most other young mammals. Play is a great way to develop social and physical skills. As you can see here, such play can be really rough. In addition to baboons, we met, especially in Uganda, many other monkeys. These black colobus monkeys lack a thumb and have only 4 digits. No wonder they look so gloomy. They live in territorial troops of 1 male and several females. They are endangered by habitat loss and hunting. Occasionally chimpanzees hunt and eat them. Also, these charming and rare host monkeys live in troops of a male with several females. We arrived at Murchison Falls Reserve on the White Nile in Uganda to see these patas monkeys. They are ground-dwelling and live in big groups of females. Most of the year these groups have only a single male. However, during the mating season additional males join these groups. During the rest of the year these males lead a solitary life or live in male groups. These mischievous vervet monkeys are rather widespread. They are also called blue monkeys because of the blue color of the testicles that dominant males proudly display. They too live in troops in which the females are of the fixed sex. Young males leave the group before the mating season, usually together with a brother or a friend. After they leave, the troop is more tolerant in accepting other young males. Vervets show alloparenting. Sexually immature young females that have no babies of their own take care of babies. There are a lot of similarities between the social patterns of the different monkeys. Most are based on multiple females and often also multiple males. In the groups, we find intricate hierarchies and mechanisms that reduce inbreeding. All these are based on highly evolved cognitive capacities. These social structures are very different from human structures that we will discuss next.